really could be so different if I had had a plan. My husband was born and raised in Italy. He came to this country when he was 32. We met when he was over on that educational exchange. Ennio is charming, extremely intelligent. He has 2 doctorate degrees. He has been a professor, an engineer. He was actually involved on the lunar excursion module when he was working for an engineering company here in the States. He was so, so Italian. He wore a black suit with red socks and his wonderful, charming Italian accent. He just kept asking me out. Finally gave in and that was it. Ennio has had 3 strokes. He needs support getting up and down, bathing, dressing, uses a walker. If I'm not here, I have to make sure somebody is here with him. He cannot be left alone. It is a full-time job. You're never off duty, day and night. If I want to do anything now, well, certainly the daycare, it's out of pocket. Pay for that out of pocket. So I was on the phone with my daughter. It said something about the cupboard is bare. There's absolutely nothing to eat in this house. I've got to get some food in. She said, well, Mom, you took the day off. Why don't you go shopping? I said, because I don't have a day off. There is no day off. I can't take your dad. He can't walk in the grocery store, and I can't leave him sitting in the car. You just don't go and do something on a whim. You have to think everything out. You have to plan it. Do I miss him? Yes. He was the most wonderful dancer. That's beautiful. And people would stop and look at us when we danced. Not because of me, because he just led me. It was wonderful. I miss dancing very much. Yeah. I miss good conversations that we had. And we try, and sometimes he talks to me, and with the aphasia, he's telling me something, and he's laughing. So I know it's something pleasant, and I just don't know what he's saying. So I just laugh with him, too. But I miss the good, long conversations, too. Yeah, I didn't, you know, you don't think it's going to, even when you're in it, you don't think it's going to happen to you. And it wasn't in my plan, yeah. I was a caregiver for my mom, too. It's not that I didn't know this could happen, but you know what, it doesn't happen to you. My husband was a strong man. I didn't think it would happen. Even after his first and his second stroke, he came back from those. You know, he was good after those. I just thought maybe that he was invincible. It really could be so different if I had had a long-term care plan. We have 4 children, 3 sons and a daughter. As much as I tell them, I still don't think they're planning yet. They still think they've got time, and you just don't know. So I keep after them. I want to make sure they've got a plan and know what that is.